Hi, my name is Nur Aisha Vita binti Samri, F20A0C82. Started began in 1971 along the Campbellstone Street of Seattle History Pike Place Market. There, where Starbucks opened its first store, offering fresh roasted coffee beans, tea, and spice from around the world for our customers to take home. The name of Starbucks was inspired by the classic tale Moby Dick, evoking the seafaring tradition of the early coffee traders. Starbucks was aspired to Chicago and Vancouver, Canada, and then on to California, Washington, D.C., and New York. By 1996, we would cross the Pacific to open our first store in Japan, followed by Europe in 1998 and China in 1999. Over the next two decades, we will grow the welcome millions of customers each week and become a part of the fabric on tens of thousands of neighborhoods all around the world.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Nur Sharina binti Muhammad. My matric number is F20A0536 and I am from SPM. Our group choose a Starbucks company that has been operating more than 10 years. Now, I would like to let you know the missions and vision of Starbucks. Firstly, the Starbucks mission statement 2021 is to inspire and nurture the human spirit, one person, one cup, and one neighborhood at a time. It is a statement that brings out critical customer-centric elements of the company. Next, the Starbucks Vision Statement 2021 is to establish Starbucks as the premium purveyor of the finest coffee in the world while maintaining our uncompromising principle why we'll grow. It outlines the critical achievements the company must realize to rank and maintain itself as a top brand within this sector.
Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Abdullah Muhammad. My matric number is F20A0656. Today, I would like to present the organization chart for Starbucks. The Chief Executive Officer for Starbucks is Howard Chow. Sarah Porter as a Human Resource Director. Gary Martin Flipfinger as a Chief Technology Officer. Followed by Scott Moore as a Chief Financial Officer. Kevin Johnson as a Chief Operating Officer. Sharon Rostin as a Global Chief Marketing Officer. Matthew Ryan for Global Chief Strategy Officer, Chris Enskov as a Europe, Middle East, Asia Manager, Belinda Wong as a China Regional Manager, and the last one is Marisa Andrada, is an America Regional Manager. That's all from me. Thank you.
Starbucks has a matrix organizational structure, which is a hybrid mixture of different rich features from the basic type of organizational structure. In this case, the structural design involves intersection among various components of the business. For example, the company's product-based division intersects with functional groups and geographic division, which in turn intersect with other parts of the organization. First, functional hierarchy. The functional hierarchy feature of Starbucks Coffee organizational structure refers to grouping based on business function. For example, the company has an HR department, a finance department, and a marketing department. Second, geographic division. Starbucks Coffee's corporate structure involves geographic division, which are based on physical location of operation. Third, product-based division. Starbucks has product-based division in its organizational structure. For example, the company has a division for coffee and related products, another division for baked goods, and another division for merchandise like mugs. Last, teams. teams are used in different parts of Starbucks Coffee's organizational structure. However, teams are most visible at the lowest organizational levels, particularly at the coffee house.
Hello, good day to everyone. I'm Sindhu Priya and I'm going to explain the main three Starbucks Corporation organizational culture. First is servant leadership. Servant leadership is where they characterize the behavioral manifestation of the company's organizational culture among leaders, which they translate to the employee's first approach, where they also develop the firm's organizational culture because the president Howard Behar believed that who care for each other employees are the one who care about customers. Next is relationship-driven approach. Starbucks also has the warm and friendly relationship approach, where this culture emphasis on relationships. Starbucks developed the global coffee culture that drives consumers' demand for the company's specialty coffee products. The final one is collaboration and communication. The corporate culture of Starbucks encourages collaborative efforts through effective communication to fulfill the orders and to fulfillment the process of efficiency.
Hi, my name is Kukani Sanna Varadaraju. My mandarin number is F208-0411. And I'm going to present about the leadership management of the Starbucks. Howard Schultz, the chief and executive officer and president of the Starbucks. He controls the biggest chain coffee in the world. We can say that his leadership style is blend of democratic and transformational style. First of all, we go with the transformational style. Okay, employees follow him because they believe and respect him. For example, Schultz offers his employee to have the right to stop shows of the company, so employees share the success of the Starbucks. Furthermore, Starbucks designs special training and program for employees. This not only motivates employees, but also makes them ready for the future in the company. He also seeks for feedback and advice from his employees, which make them feel empowered and encouraged. The second thing is democratic style of the leadership. Howard looks for employees who are team players and passionate enough. He promotes company and he also do believe in employees are more decision making. Okay, the third thing is opportunities of Howard's coverage in the success. Okay, the first thing is embrace social media. Starbucks uses Instagram to advertise its brand. This is not only to showcase products, but also to share images of the customers. The second thing is be innovative. Starbucks began free Wi-Fi in 2010. Starbucks has a new instant coffee machine. The company allows customers to pay for product with an iPhone app. Starbucks became the first to do like this. The third thing is choose the right partners. Since 2006, Starbucks and Apple work together. People can purchase songs on iTunes that they heard in Starbucks. So, and he also have a key-minded people.
Hi, I'm Johnny Jason and my metric number is F20B0724 and I'm here to talk about the strategic of Starbucks Corporation organization. These are the four types of strategics in Starbucks. The first one, offering third place experience. Starbucks stores are effectively positioned as a third place away from home and work, where people can spend time in a relaxed and comfortable environment with their friends or alone. Customers are even welcome to get their work done in a Starbucks store. Starbucks stores are meticulously designed to make customers stay longer, buy more, and return in another visit. Secondly, selling coffee of the highest quality. Starbucks business strategy can be classified as product differentiation according the coffee chain giant focus on the quality of each product and customer pay premium price for high quality and excellent customer service as one of the solid source of Starbucks. Competitive advantage further increase the attractiveness of the coffee retailer. The third one are international market expansion with a focus of emerging economic is one of the key elements of Starbucks business strategy on long-term perspective. The share of company revenues from China, Asia Pacific, global market segment increased to 14% in 2016 from 7% in the previous year. In total, 2,719 new Starbucks stores opened during the last 2 years. Last strategic in Starbucks is integrating technology into various business processes. Starbuck is adamant when it says that the purpose of new technology is not just to improve its website or to produce payment quicker for people who are waiting in line. The coffee chain achieves technology-related value additional via integrating technology into a wide range of business processes and procedure, such as new product development, communication of the marketing message, completing sale and monitoring the value of customer satisfaction. The most notable example for value creation via technological integration by Starbucks include the launch of mobile order and pay feature, which allowed customers to buy without getting in line. That's all from me. Thank you.